Let's find out which layouts were affected by this change. Most likely, the floor plan and the section will have to be republished. Display the layout book in the Navigator. Right-click on the topmost item from the layout book of the project and choose Update from the context menu. This will update all drawings placed on layouts, including the renderings as well. This may take a minute or two. Once the update process is completed, we will be able to see those layouts where the marked elements appear. The affected layouts will be highlighted in the layout book of the Navigator. Apparently, there are more layouts affected than we expected. Remember, the modified slab element appears on all those layouts in some way that are highlighted in blue. We'll sort these out later. For now, switch to the view map of the Navigator. Open the S1 building section. We will highlight the slab change visually here as well. Open the Change Tool Settings dialog. Display the General panel. Instead of creating a new change again, select the Place Linked Marker option for marker type. Set the reference to the previously created CH1 slab change. A change can have many revision clouds linked, but revision clouds can belong to one change only. Click OK to close the dialog. Zoom into the entrance area of the section view. Draw a revision cloud around the slab part as presented on the screen. Place the marker. The marker will also become part of the element list of the Change Manager palette. Let's create the revised issue now. Click the Issue History button on the Change Manager palette. Click the New Issue. And then click Continue Anyway in the upcoming dialog. Enter Construction Revision for the name of the new issue. Click OK. The previously highlighted elements of the layout book appear in this issue. As mentioned earlier, some of these layouts might be irrelevant in this case, so let's remove them by clicking the X mark beside the S2 building section, all four elevations, as well as the renderings layouts. In the same manner, it's always possible to add layouts manually to an issue by clicking the Add Layout button if you believe that for some reason it's relevant. For now, click the Close Issue button. Click Continue Anyway if necessary. Finally, click OK to close the dialog. Some of the blue highlighted layers will disappear from the layout book of the Navigator. These layouts that were marked as changed but were removed manually from the issue are still highlighted in blue in the Navigator. These can be used further in a subsequent issue or can be ignored completely. We'll see how to handle these layouts later. Display Publisher in the Navigator. If you want to publish the revised layouts, you can do that here. Display all publisher sets by clicking the arrow button once. Notice that the affected publisher sets are also highlighted in green. Open the Two Layouts publisher set. The changed individual items, the ground floor plan and the S1 section item, are also marked in green. Now that we have the first round of revisions, we would like to make them appear on the layouts as a form of documentation, as a revision history table, so we can see the revision history of each published layout. ARCHICAD provides a flexible GDL object for this purpose. Switch to the layout book in the Navigator. Open the A4 Portrait Master layout. Select the Object tool in the toolbox and open its Settings dialog. Enter Revision in the search field. Select the Revision History Detailed object. Display the Preview and Positioning panel of the dialog. Make sure that the rotation angle is set to 0. Display the Revision History Settings panel. Display the Additional Display Options page. Check the Show Watermark on Work in Progress Layouts checkbox. Select the Marker Change layer and click OK to apply all changes. Place the revision history table into the empty cell of the master layout. Select it and resize it so that it fits the width of the middle cell. Pick up the parameters of the revision history table with the help of the eyedropper tool in the toolbar. Open the A2 Landscape Master Layout from the Layout book. Inject the previously picked parameters to the revision history table displayed on this layout. Open the West Elevation or any other highlighted layout and notice that the Work in Progress text appears above the revision history table. This means that the layout contains changes that have not been issued yet. Let's change some windows and document the changes in an upcoming issue. We still have some layouts highlighted, and we know that we would not want to use them from now on. Right-click on the West Elevation layout in the Layout book. Select the Layout Settings option from the context menu. Display the Revision History panel of the dialog. Click the X mark beside the name of the change so it will not be associated with the layout anymore. Click OK to close the dialog. Repeat the same steps with all the remaining highlighted layouts. Once finished, you can continue marking the new noteworthy changes. In this chapter, you shared the design with other project participants using 2D and 3D documentation methods. You learned the process of creating automatically updated layouts, the concept of publisher sets, and IFC data exchange. Congratulations! You've completed this training guide. We hope that you've learned many new skills while exploring the modeling and documentation capabilities of ARCHICAD. By now, you should have all the necessary knowledge to begin your own projects with ARCHICAD and complete them successfully. If you're interested in the advanced modeling capabilities of ARCHICAD, we suggest that you complete the ARCHICAD Training Series Volume 4, Advanced ARCHICAD. The learning site on Graphisoft.com provides additional free training materials, online seminars, and books. Should you have any questions regarding ARCHICAD or other Graphisoft products, please visit the Graphisoft Help Center, our online knowledge base, at helpcenter.graphisoft.com. Please feel free to contact Graphisoft and its worldwide partners with further questions at www.graphisoft.com. We look forward to seeing you in the ARCHICAD user community.